Assalamu alaikum. How are you all? This is Hafiza Fatma, your general science teacher for level 1. Today we will start our chapter number 7, movement. In this chapter, we will first see that we will learn about force and movement. First, we will see what is force. Force is push or pull. When we push or pull things, we are using force. Now, what is movement? Movement is basically a changing position of anything, or it is an act or process of changing, process of moving. For example, if we enter the room and we want to close the door, it's like we push the door to close it, and when we want to open the door, then we pull the door to open it. Second example is toy car. You see that these cars can't move by themselves. Now we have to push these cars to make them move. When something changes its position, it's called movement. Now you can see that you and the living things around you can move all the time. Our world is full of moving things. Look at this picture. Here you can see that there are boys and children who are enjoying and playing. How will the football move? The football will move when the boys kick it. They apply force to push the ball to go to the goal or anywhere. Second is, what is the man doing to the baby buggy? He is pushing it to make it move. Third is, why is the woman pushing the swing? She is pushing the swing by using a push force to make it move. What movement did you see in that picture? Everyone is pushing or pulling. So when we push or pull something, we make them move. Pushes and pulls are forces we apply to certain things. Living things. When we move our arm or legs, we are using force. Everything needs a force to make it move. Living things can move on their own. People, animals move in their different ways, but non-living things cannot move. Non-living things need force to make them move. We also use some machines to help us move things. Now, this is a concept check. In this concept check, there are pictures. In this picture, you will see that look at these pictures, which movement is a push and which movement is a pull. You have to circle the pull movements with red and push movement with blue. In the first picture, a lady is helping a patient in a wheelchair by using a pushing movement to his wheelchair so that it will start moving. In the second picture, a man is pulling a horse to walk on a lead role. So he is using a pulling force here. In the third picture, a boy is pulling his luggage bag. In the fourth picture, a man is trying to catch a fish with a rod. How do these living things move? There are pictures of things which are in moving, which are in action, which are doing something. So first one, we will see that there are few words which are used for movement. Number one is crawl. Crawl is a type of movement it that babies do normally. It's a 2 foot and 2 arm movement. Second one is hop. Hop is a movement we call hopping. It means that jumping with 1 foot and landing on other. So then a person pushes his front leg first and then pulls his back legs in this hopping movement. Third one is fly. You can see that birds and beagles fly in the air. So fly is also a type of movement. Swim. Swim means, next one is swim. Swim is like a movement in which we move through the water without touching the bottom surface. It's a to and fro motion in water which fishes do to move. Now, second is run. To move forward quickly upon 2 feet by alternatively making a short jump off. Next is gallop. Gallop is a manner of movement of horse during which all four legs are off the ground simultaneously. jog. Jog is a type of movement called jogging, and it's like a faster than a walk and but slower than a run. Pounce. Pounce means that to suddenly move forward and attack someone or something. If lion or cat attack on its prey, that type of movement is called as pounce. Now we will see how non-living things move. Non-living things cannot move on their own. These things move by some factors that can be air. For example, this is a windmill, right? This windmill cannot move on their own. The force of wind makes the windmill to work. So he uses wind as their source, as their force. Second ones are machines. There are few machines, for example, these trains. There are some tractor machine construction, and there is a wheelbarrow. All these things are considered as machine, and they have a system which they help them these things to move. If we push them or pull them, they can make a move. With the help of us and with the help of machines, these non-living things move. Your homework for today is do reading of whole chapter number 7. That was all for today. Thank you.